Hello and welcome to St. Mary's Now, a partnership between the Enterprise newspaper and the Forrest Center TV video production program. I'm Dylan Casoni-Burch.
And I'm James King.
And here's the latest news from the Enterprise. The St. Mary's County delegation convened last Friday in a closed meeting to vote on their stance on a number of proposals that had been brought forth by the St. Mary's County Commissioners last October. After a reporter inquired about the delegation's decisions, Delegate Brian Cosby told the Enterprise that the three delegates and the state senator representing St. Mary's voted unanimously on several bills that would specifically impact the county, including changes to the county's Open Meetings Act, the decoupling of the county government's debt from the St. Mary's County Metropolitan Commission debt, and an increase in the public accommodations tax.
Approval for a solar farm in St. Mary's County has been delayed on account of objection from the nearby naval base. The application for the Whitetail Solar Project was filed last year by Light Source Renewable Energy Development on August 26, requesting authority to construct a 20-megawatt alternating current solar photovoltaic facility along with associated interconnection facilities in the county. The facility was estimated to take up to approximately 81 acres and was planned to be built in Lexington Park near the homegrown farm market in Mattapani Rural Legacy Area. A January 6 letter from Captain Christopher Cox, commanding officer of the base, pointed out that the project is located within miles of the center airfield of NAS Pax River and could potentially impact military operations and readiness.
About 2 years ago, Bill Dolans, now 51, realized he had weighed more than he ever had in his life. Dolans, a software engineer who had previously been a consultant for the Navy, began his war on cubicle body in 2017 after learning how to keep himself on track with a regular routine. Dolans created a timeline for himself which included specific dates for each fitness goal. He started participating in local races and began working with a personal trainer. Dolan said that now he is more focused on his health than he is with his weight, stating, "I've ran races where people of all different sizes will pass me."
St. Mary's College hosts their annual Martin Luther King prayer breakfast next Monday. The January 20th breakfast will begin at 6:30 a.m. and cost $10 payable at the door. The purpose is to take time as a community to pay homage to the life and legacy of Dr. King. Leonard Brown, the college's vice president for student affairs, said on Monday. All are welcome to attend, he said, adding that the program also aims to help the community think about our responsibility moving forward, based on all that work of King and other civil rights advocates.
On Friday night, the Lonatown Raiders sent their fans home happy with a resounding 66-38 victory over the visiting Calvert Cavaliers in the Southern Maryland Athletic Conference Chesapeake Division battle. Raiders senior guard Tyreek Herbert said, "This is the best the team has been in a long time, and our record and our support we get at home shows it." The win over the Cavaliers marked the first smack Chesapeake Division game for Leonardtown, putting them 1-0 as the Raiders have high hopes entering divisional play this season.
On Thursday night's wrestling match, Lackey's Paris Blake lifted Lackey to a 35-34 victory over the Braves. Blake said, "I just didn't want to let my team down. I wanted to give it my all to make sure we got the win." Lackey's win closed a Southern Maryland Athletic Conference tri-match hosted by the Chargers that also included Leonardtown. The Raiders left Lackey's gym, the owners of two wins, dominating Lackey 56-11 to open the night before dispatching Choptacon 54-18.
This news brief has been provided by the Enterprise. For more details, visit smbnews.com. That's all we have for you on this edition of St. Mary's Now. I'm Dylan Casoni-Burch.
And I'm James King.
Signing off.